Right, so to ratify Calgary, we need 67 senators. There are basically three pools of votes. The yeses, of whom there aren't enough. But then there are two kinds of no votes. The defense hawks, who tend to take their cues from the military, and those who will never vote for any treaty because they're afraid of loss of U.S. sovereignty, a.k.a. the black helicopter crowd.
Carlos Morejon jumps to mind.
Fun fact, his wife Vicky did retweet the rescue video.
His heartlessness completes her.
Long story short, ma'am, getting the votes before the congressional recess will be a pretty heavy lift.
Yep.
Gordon Becker is your answer.
Okay.
Mike B., ma'am.
Yes, with his impeccable timing. Mike, this is my new policy advisor cat, Sandoval cat. Mike, my cat.
Mr. Barno, good to meet you. Your reputation precedes you.
As does yours. Didn't you go crazy or something?
Actually, I just moved to an avocado farm in California.
That sounds like the same thing.
What's this really about? Ah, troubled by a nagging feeling your dog likes me more than you.
I will have you know that Gordon and I are in a really good place right now.
Gordon? Wait. I'm sorry, Gordon the dog, as in Gordon the sect?
For the record, he's named after G. Gordon Liddy, who also had his quirks but was fanatically loyal.
To an unworthy master. Makes sense.
Getting back to the Gordon that matters, tell us how sect death figures into this.
Way to keep us on track. You're no Nadine, but I appreciate the effort. Look, even if a senator in their heart wants to vote yes, they can't look weak on defense, so you have to give them some cover.
And getting Becker to come out in favor of ratifying Calgary does just that. I like it. Blake, give me a meeting with SecDef, will you?
So, I hear you're throwing a party this weekend, and Bonnie Duncan's not even in the ground yet. I love it. Sounds like the White House is having you lay the groundwork for a run. Oh, she didn't tell you? Oops.
Because it's not happening.
Well, you just turned POTUS down?
Well, Russell. Look, I'm not into all that backslapping, join the club malarkey. Oh, and I don't want to be president.
Although, if you did throw the party, you could use the informal setting, not to mention official Washington's curiosity with the glamorous McCords, as a lure to troll for more treaty votes.
So not glamorous, just... But nevertheless, I like it.
Right?
That's a good idea.
No. No, it's not a good idea. It's a terrible idea. These parties are nonpartisan, therefore they're actually fun. I mean, sure, tell everyone you want to run for president, but don't dance on poor Bunny's grave talking politics.
Blake, call the White House. Tell Russell Jackson I'll throw the stupid party. Don't say stupid.